we are going to start with unit number 8, energy and its form, page number 77. Energy is basically described as the ability to do work. So there are two types of energies, potential energy and kinetic energy. In the previous lesson, we discussed about potential energy in detail, that it is the energy that is stored in an object due to its position, and we also studied about its types. And today we are going to study about kinetic energy in detail. So starting with the definition, kinetic energy is the energy in a body due to its motion. So whenever a thing is moving, motion basically means the movement. So we are going to discuss about the things that move, and when the things move, they have an energy that is known as kinetic energy. Kinetic energy, page number 79. It is the energy in a body due to its motion. It is written as capital A E dot capital K dot E. Kinetic energy of the object depends upon two things. So basically, kinetic energy, as we have discussed, that it is related to the movement. Everything that is moving, if you take example of a moving bus, when it stops, it does not have kinetic energy. But when it is moving, it has kinetic energy. The moving tap water, when the water is flowing from the tap, that has kinetic energy. The blowing wind, it also has kinetic energy because the wind is moving. Kinetic energy basically depends upon two things, the mass of the object and the speed of the object. So here we can compare a car, it is moving, and a train, it's also moving. But between these two, the train will have more kinetic energy because it has more mass and it moves faster as compared to the car. So here we can say that the train has more kinetic energy because the greater the mass and the speed, the greater is the kinetic energy. So this is all about your kinetic energy. We are going to discuss about the forms of kinetic energy. Your page number is 80. There are basically four forms of kinetic energy. I am going to explain you each form one by one. So the first form of kinetic energy we are going to discuss is the heat. So in your book, heat is a form of energy. It is the movement of particles within the substance. When we heat up an object, its particles move and collide faster. Heat can move from one place to another. Heat cooks our food. It changes solid into liquid and liquid into vapor. The sun is our major source of heat. So basically our sun, it is the major source of heat, and heat, when something is heated, then its atoms start moving faster, and heat can start colliding with each other, and heat can move from one place to another. When we cook our food, we basically need heat. Without heat, we can't cook our food, and heat changes a solid into liquid, and when you heat that liquid further, it changes into vapor. So heat is very important. It is a form of energy made by motion of molecules. The more the motion of movement of molecules, the more will be your heat. The second form that we are going to discuss is your light. Here you can see the light. Light is a form of energy. The sun is a major source of light. Light helps the plants to make food. Basically, your major source of light is the sun. Sun is very important for the plants because plants need to make their own food through the process of photosynthesis. Without the process of photosynthesis, there will be no light. There are some calculators known as solar calculators. They also work when they get the sunlight. The light passing through the lens of a camera makes an image on the camera. So sunlight is very important because if you want to take an image from the camera, then the camera needs light passing through its lens. So this is all about light. There are basically three, if you look at this picture, then here it is written, three sources of light energy in the form of sun, fire and electricity. Now we are going to discuss about electrical energy. Electric energy caused by the movement of electrons. So here if you see in this picture, then it is written that it is energy due to the movement of electrons, easily transported through power lines and converted into other forms of energy. So basically the appliances that you use, they convert electric energy into different energy. Like if you are using an oven, it converts electric energy into heat energy. So electric energy is basically because of movement of electrons, and it is very important and in our home because it is used in many of our appliances at home. And lightning is another example of electric energy. Now, the last form of energy that we are going to discuss is the sound energy. Sound energy is the movement of molecules in the air that produces vibrations. So basically, the more vibrations are produced, you will have more sound and more sound energy. Sound is a form of energy. Sound energy is produced by vibrating body. So whenever the body is vibrating, it is producing sound. Here you can also do experiment that if you take a tape recorder or anything like your phone, the thing that can vibrate, and you put some pieces of paper on it, then when the sound you put on the sound, then you will see that the paper pieces will start vibrating. This is because the molecules, the atoms, they start vibrating because of the sound wave. And in this way, the energy in sound is far less than the other forms of energy. So basically, sound energy is low as compared to other forms of energy like heat, electric, and light. They are more powerful than the sound energy. So this is all about your different forms of energy.